Hi guys, welcome to our channel, Canny, You Can Be. Friends, are you in dilemma that how to save and run the programming tool software? Then have a look at this video. At first, open the tool software. Here I am using Microvision 5. Now, to create a new project, select the option project. And then here you can find an option called New Microvision Project. Select that one. And here, give the name of the project which you are going to create here. Okay? Here I'm going to give the name as LED Interface. Sorry, button interfaces LED. Button interface LED. Okay. And give the extension as .c. Here I'm going to write the program in the C language. That's why I have given the extension as .c. And you can give whatever extension you need in which language you are going to write the program. Okay, and then after giving the extension, save it. Click on save. And here you can find a new window. Then select the device name, which device you are going to use in this tool software. Okay, to select the device here, if you find an option called Atmel, then click on Atmel. If you click, means here you can find add symbol now. Click on add symbol. Then you can find a number of devices in the Atmel. Here it is not Atmel, right? It is a Atmel wireless and micro UC. I need 8089C51. It will be available only in Atmel. That's why no, I can't find that option here. So I'm going to search here 8089C51. Okay, this is the device which I'm going to use in this software, 8089C51. If you find the option directly, you can select that one. See, here you can find that one, 8089C51. Okay, select that one. If not, you can search it in a search bar and then click on OK. And copy startup.a51 to project folder. A new project folder will be created to you. It will be copied there. Okay, yes. Again, click it on S. So, a new project will be, file will be started here. This is the target one. You can find this one in a project file. Okay. Then give on a add symbol. Click on add symbol so that you can find a source group, right? Again, click on add symbol. A file is created to you. Okay. Double click on a source group. Okay. Give the name of the device which you are going to add in that source group. Already I have given what's that as, yeah, here it is. Button interface LED.c. Yeah, select that one and give the extension, or if not, no need, .c. And you can find here option called as add. Means you have to add this one into the source group, okay? Add. And then close it. Now you can see that after clicking add here in the source group, this file is added, button interface. Okay. Friends, if you don't find this project file here, then you can find that one. Suppose here there is no project file. See, nothing else here. Here is nothing else. It's an empty window. Suppose if you don't find anything here, then click on a view option and there select a project window. Okay. So that all the project details will be viewed here. Everything you can see in this project window, which one is going to save where, it will be easy to you. Okay. And then double click on this button interface, which one you added right now. Okay. Double click on that on your program file. So that a new window comes here. Here you can write the program. Yeah, it will take a lot of time to write all the program, right? So already I have written. And I'm going to paste here. Yeah, this is the program which is required to me. Okay. and then later you have already you have written, huh? So is there any error or not? You can find here, this is the interface translator, so that by clicking on this you can find whether the error is present or not. Okay, click on it. Compiling button interface LED. Here you can see that interface LED dot C, zero errors and zero warnings. Oh, okay, let's see. Here I have missed the semicolon. Okay, again I am going to run it. Translate. Oh no, we got the error. There is one error. Yeah, that's why place the semicolon here. This is the error, and then again translate it. Yeah, zero errors and warnings. Okay, fine. This fine. This code is fine. And then build this one. This is the build option, means to convert the given program into the hexa file. Means all the program will be written in hexadecimal. That's why to convert all the program in hexa file, we are going to click on this option. Okay. Again. Rebuild. And after, you can find the option called as a target one, right? Just right click on it. You can find the options for target one. Okay. Select that one. You can find this window here. In the target, here it will work for 11.0592 megahertz. Okay. In XTAL of megahertz, give year in which megahertz your system is going to work. Okay, I have given that 11.0592. Getting to the option called as output, you can find output here now. Select that one, output. And then to create a hexa file, just create here, check the option called as a create hexa file. Okay, so that hexa file will be created. Before I told you that if you click on this build option, your hexa file will be created. Before that only you have to do this one. Yeah, create a hexa file. Okay, and then click on OK. Now again translate the program, check any error is present or not, build the file into the hexa file. Yeah, and then rebuild it. Yeah, your hexa file will be created in your PC. After checking all the errors and to run the program, click on a edit window and then go into the configuration. Here you can find colors and fonts. Click on that, colors and fonts, and select ASM editor files. And here in the element section, select option default. And in the fonts, if you click on the fonts, you can find number of options. Okay, then there select consolas and click on OK. And then OK. Next, getting to the debug option, and here start or stop debug session. You can find the comment here and then give on OK. Okay, your program is going to run here. Now here we have given port 1 and port 2, right? Two ports we are going to use. In port 1, second terminal, and in port 2, third pin. Okay. Then get into the peripherals and select input output ports. In that we are going to use two ports, right? One is port 1. And again get into the peripherals, input and output ports, select port 2. Okay. This is the peripherals which we need. And in the program, again after getting to the debug, start run. Okay, now the program will start run here. In the program we have given that if button is equals to 0, LED will be 1. Here port 2 is belonging to button, right? In port 2, third pin will be act as a button. This is the port 2, and 0, 1, 2, 3, third pin is the button. Okay, if it is in on condition, if button is equals to 0, LED will be 1. So this is 0, then you can find that LED is equals to 1. LED in port 1, second terminal. This is the port 1 and this is the second pin. Okay. If port 1, port 2, button is equals to 0, LED will be 1. If it is 1, LED will be 0. Okay. See, here the option is going to change. Yeah. This is the process how to run the program here in a Keel software. And now to stop running the program, just get into the debug and then click on stop. Okay. Running the program will be stopped. Before I told that, if you rebuild this one, hey, hexa file will be created, right? Where the program will be saved, hexa file program means, in your PC. Just check it in your PC. I saved all the programs in this new folder, Keel programs. So everything will be stored here too. There you can find option called objects. In the, this is the program interface LED hexa file. This is the required hexa file to us. Yeah, this is the program in hexa file. Okay friends, this is the process how to run the program in a Keel software. And that's it. See you soon friends.